Positioning for the B pick. Bugly with a flash to try and force him off the angle. Fully white screen. Does indeed have to fall back. Tempo though for Bugly. And actually it's gonna be Sponge though. Opens up first frag of the round. This is playing from Sandbags. Trade though from Adren. Havoc onto Fugly.
Again at a deficit, this time 3-4 for Liquid. Nitro stuck at middle, has assistance from his teammate coming up over the top. Just gonna fall off the player at white box for the Renegade side. Now regrouping, Liquid heading over toward the checkers. We were experiencing some technical difficulties, so welcome back. Hopefully we got it resolved and can keep providing you the action. Who needs sleep when you got the hype? Hiko versus 3.
Here we go. See if we can provide an entertaining clutch for us here as he's got 45 seconds. And he'll make his way up to the bomb site. See if he actually commits to this bomb plan or just opts to fake. And he will actually commit to it, so bomb now being set. Some utility still on Renegades, and Hiko just desperately trying to find a 1v1 here again. Don't want to allow Renegades to surround him. Here we go, taking the first fight, but it's Azur. He's going to hit that shot immediately, and, well, so nice of Yam. Got to put out that fire for his teammate.
A waste of $300, Chad.
I suppose. it's a courteous move, though. It's a sign of friendliness.
Is that a Canadian thing?
Yeah, something like that. 5-4, Renegades. Now, again, 4 in a row, and Bank shows no sign of slowing down the growth. And I'm sure Liquid have other plans.
I'm thinking Renegades should just give away a big lead in all their games.
Right? Once
they start rallying, they just don't stop. So here we go, Liquid. The majority of their players towards the A side, just one anchoring down towards Sunshine. Is Liquid planning on committing? Not so sure yet. Lacking a whole lot of utility. Only Adren and Hiko with the smoke as Havoc will deal with the only player from Liquid towards the B side. Waiting for Liquid to commit in towards A here as nobody looks like they're falling back. As Yam grabs another 4 Renegades. Not a lot of utility again. Azur from the catwalk, that's gonna be 2. And Yam to finish the round. 5 rounds matched by the 5 in a row by Liquid.
And Adren's gonna call for a pause here as 11th round. I wonder if it is going to be a tactical one or if they're having issues. Take a look at the player cam here. Does look like they're chatting away. So, Renegade's going to ask the question and, well, we're informed as well. There's a tactical pause. And to be fair, kind of understandable. Haven't been able to work very much in the last 5 rounds.
So 5 rounds loss bonus for Liquid. Going to get a whole bunch of money in the neck, so they can go for Tech 9 armor or whatever their preferred upgraded pistol is. But where is it going to go? There's Azur having another performance. Not quite on to par to train, but he is showing up here. But moving on to the CT side, I'm thinking Renegades need to win. Not the remainder, but most of them to have a shot versus Liquid. Moving on to Liquid CT side. This is crazy. It's so weird that Renegades goes down that many rounds and then just rallies back in a hurry. This time it was 5, last time it was 10.
Yeah, indeed, last time was 10. And again, they matched the 10 as well, rallying
yeah,
all the way back. So here we go, unpause being called for round 11. About to go live here. Liquid with pistol armor and, of course, full loss bonus. See what they can make work with. 3 smokes, a couple nades, actually, sorry, 4 smokes.
So they're going to try a mini execute in Liquid, and this may be some for information if they try to hit it on the gun round to follow. We're going to find out. Not a ton of nades for the Liquid side, but enough to go for their execute. So in comes the Tech 9 train, 1P250 Azur from the forklift. And tons of smokes in the site for Liquid. They are making it around. Somebody boosted up on top of the site. Now getting out of the smoke towards quad. Renegades hanging on for the time being. Yam and Havoc with a double op setup. It's trades 2-for-2 thus far. As Renegades getting the retake. Still no bomb plant. Hiko is going to grab the advantage for Liquid. JKS finds himself.
Oof.
Versus 3 of Liquid.
Havoc just trying to dive bomb into the bomb site. Goes down to Adren. And JKS, this is a doable round as Fugly low Adren on a single hit point. Hiko Gotta be the point man here as the AWP. They haven't quite got that bomb set. JKS utilizing a smoke towards Forkin. We'll see how Liquid decides to play this. I imagine very passively. JKS just hoping for some sort of peek here from the Liquid side, but giving him nothing at all. Eventually peeking is Hiko, just for a moment though, just to tease him. As Fugly does get lit up, but time is of the essence. JKS just keeping him around here.
JKS, as long as he keeps them in the bomb site.
Oh, what a tap.
Will these two members go down? Oh, there's still plenty of time left on the bomb. Can't quite hear that. Still enough money for the Renegades. And now a big round for Liquid. They drop this one back on the saves. Condition nobody wants to have. And a double op set up again for the Renegades. And just a simple 2-on-2.
Let's see, Sponge taking a lot of damage early here towards White Box, down to 19 hit points. That should affect his play. Actually, still fairly out in the open here. Molotov will prevent anybody heading up on that blue spot. And let's see, Go does have a partner towards Squeaky this time around. It's Adren. Gonna pop open the door for him. Adren, tunnel vision onto Highway. And it's gonna be Azra and Sponge trying to utilize a boost here. Sponge, see how long he decides to wait around. Again, he's very low at hit points, so might even just do a bit of a small peek, just only his head visible, utilize that headshot angle.
So Liquid is planning, or it looked like they were planning on falling back towards B, but somebody has forgotten the bomb. Or is this all part of the plan? Is Liquid now smoke off middle? Two smokes providing a wall. Renegades, Sponge.
Oh,
finds his
Sponge
way behind enemy lines, grabs two headshots of Liege. Will respond. Now 3-on-4 for Renegades. Excuse me, Liquid, but still haven't grabbed the bomb. In 30 seconds left, Liquid is running out of time. They got to pick a bomb site.
Yep, as you're going to see Fugly makes a shot onto Azer. And it's going to create a 3-on-3, but with 15 seconds remaining, we'll see if Havoc can try and stop this bomb plant. Looking towards Highway, does find one. And now it's going to be a Liege planning save. Spots Hiko towards Quad. Quick shot, though. Hiko drops Havoc, and it's 2-on-2.
Yeah, has a Liege trapped inside of the site. His reactions have to be swift if he's going to do this. He's going to throw the Molotov. A Liege has to escape. Misses. Oh, a Liege peeks and gets him. But now Hiko versus JKS. This would be a huge round for Liquid to pick up. Can't afford to drop it back on the save if they do. JKS approaching. Doesn't seem to know that Hiko is still hanging out at Quad. Very quick tap by JKS going around the Quad. Hiko with the headshot, and he's going to take the one-on-one.
Very nice shot there from Hiko as JKS can't get it done. And seven rounds now for the Liquid side. And let's see, 7,500 on Azer. Yam with a good chunk of change as well. Looks like he will invest in the round. Yam bought. Okay, no, actually, Yam just buying. Okay, all right. Yam goes down to 400. Havoc, I don't know. Laser, would you call that a misbuy, or is there an intention behind that?
It's definitely a misbuy, but I mean, looking at their money, Azer will have enough to drop Yam, so that's the only thing I could really think of that I could make a case for this buy. Is a Liege holding the A-main push, because they line up for him, two for a Liege and Yam. I mean, the problem with buying an AWP and the rest of your teammates don't have much, you gotta play around that op.
Yeah.
Instead, Nitro, gonna create Havoc. That waste of a bunch of money, but Havoc with the 1D. Yeah.
Let's see if he's got more in his system here, as a Liege will take him down. Decent damage dealt to a Liege, but again, we'll see how this buy turns out. Again, that op making it into the last round, and you know, it looks like they're going to be all right. So, well calculated as they get everything. Well, they don't have an op in this round, so again, uncertain if that was meant to be there. But didn't work out nonetheless, so neither here nor there as Liquid. We have Nitro flashing into the smoke out middle. Sponge slowly lurking his way up. And Sponge, one thing I've noticed from him is even if he takes a ton of damage, he's such an intelligent player in finding positions where he could still be effective.
Yeah, I agree entirely. Now Liquid, they don't go for the fast mid boost. They did get boosted up mid, but they don't execute right away. Going behind enemy lines is Sponge. He's gonna bring down Fugly. It changes everything for Liquid. Sponge almost finds another. And a liquid. It's one for one so far. Elige, Hiko, pretty low heading towards the B bomb site. It's been quite a while since Liquid have taken a stroll this way. And JKS, will he get caught cold inside of the B site? Teammate Havoc on its way. He's not an it. He's a he, Chad.
Indeed, he is. You should see his beard. As we got Nitro looking to lead this charge towards the B bomb site. And again, like you had stated, Havoc helping out JKS. As the smoke goes down, but Havoc could potentially work off of this. As you can see, there's a gap. JKS, Molotov onto his position. He's found a nice toasty spot. Havoc goes down immediately, though, and JKS, they did not expect him to be in that spot, but only netting him one frag. Yam chimes in onto Elige. It is going to be a 2-on-2 with 10 seconds remaining, so collecting the bomb here potentially. No, it's not going to be so. Adren can't find anything, and it'll be a Renegades round.
Yeah, the round was lost when Hiko goes down, getting into the bomb site. I'm not sure if it was Azur or Yam who got that frag onto Hiko, but it is going to get them their sixth. And despite winning, looks like Liquid is going to have a better buy than the Renegades. So I lied. Pretty similar. So Liquid for their last round on the T side. What strategy will they employ for Renegades? Four players over towards A. Liquid haven't taken B fast. So feeling safe for Renegades to stack this A bomb site initially as Azur on the shroud spot. They're boosting another player inside of the site as well. So vertical on the A site hold as Yam peeking into Squeaky from the connector. Tags up Adren a bit, but no kills.
No frags as of yet. Adren with the bomb is heading away from A main, actually mauling over. Looks like he's going to put Elige up and over the top after he lines up the smoke here. Again, still three at A. Sponge working white box. Jump peeking here. Going to spot some players, and he does see them coming up over the top. Nice flashbang from Sponge, but not exactly as maybe effective as he would have hoped. But he's actually going to be fully white screened here, and this is going to be a big moment if he can come up with the frag. Not going to be so. Elige will find one. Nitro onto Havoc. 3-on-3 as 25 seconds remain. Azur spotted up above, but he is not going to go down. Finally does so. JKS versus Hiko.
Hiko has to grab the bomb here. He will collect it. He won the 1-versus-1 JKS last time. Looking for some revenge. Hiko not going to go for the plant. I'm not sure if he spotted JKS inside of the smoke now. Planting inside of the corner. JKS has knows exactly where he is. Hiko going to go for the plant. JKS spams him down. Gets the revenge. 8-7 half for Liquid.
There we go. So, again, Liquid starting off with 5 rounds in a row. And then, well, like we had stated, just rallying back in fairly even at half. And in our esports gaming odds on this match, 1.319 for Team Liquid. 2.935 for Renegades. And of course, just a special thanks to other sponsors as well. We got OP Skins here with their booth. Of course, Azubu. We've got BenQ, CyberPower, TT Esports, Esports Arena. We really do appreciate all the support as we'll see Liquid now on the CT side. Hiko will be with the Dualies and, well, see how this round's gonna go. He's got a smoke towards B, but as we can see, the Renegades working towards A, possibly.
Two players boosted up, ready to go. Wow, they both eat a nade. If they didn't have armor, they'd be almost dead at this point. But now comes the split. Fugly on to Havoc from the Squeaky trade frag by JKS, but now comes the second wave from the Renegade side coming up from Connector, but they are getting flanked now from middle. They have the smoke up now, dissipating. Yam somehow dodging, staying alive. Azur eats the bullet meant intended for Yam, but Yam will go down as well to Hiko, busting out those dualies on the pistol round. Bomb has been planted. 2-on-4, Sponge and JKS. Sponge onto Elige. Still the player at quad, hasn't revealed himself. Sponge is doing everything now. JKS peeking out from the quad, headshot onto Nitro. This 2-versus-4, unreal from Renegades.
That was insane. JKS with a triple kill. And Renegades going to secure the T-side pistol round. And what is Liquid's response to this? Looks like He will be disciplined, going with the save here. No force by, and, well, Renegades with rifles on absolutely everyone. So, of course, this means won't be able to build a bank account as much. We'll see if they can keep everybody alive. And, of course, if anybody does go down, that is a rifle dropped.
Yeah, so going a safe way instead of the path towards more money, which is the riskier. And Liquid 5.7s, P250s, no utility. As they're playing a 2-1-2 with the 5.7s, you've heard me commentate before, definitely not a fan of playing default with pistols, but if you have 5.7s, and that changes everything. And a loud up middle, Renegades, nobody peeking it for Liquid. Fugly gonna take the peek. His teammate dies in the meantime though, so only one for Fugly. Now Liquid. Not sure if they want to even go for the retake here, just try to find some way to collect the rifles out of Renegades. There's no SMGs.
As Dren towards Z. Got a leash still in the middle. Hiko is bouncing around on the truck. JKS spots him though and will deal with him. And we'll see if Alige and Adren can make something work. Yam dealing with Alige. Now only Adren, and we'll spot a hopping Yam. Takes him down to 5 hit points, but they'll survive with 4 players. Again, considering they did have rifles on all their players, it's good for them that they only lose one.
A Liquid on an eco. I'd also like to thank everybody but our lovely sponsor, Enermax. Some sick cases, coolers, power supplies. Tons of stuff you can grab, and also they got some cool shirts. And if you haven't checked out the Ostrog Pink, I strongly recommend doing so. It is super neat. Nobody wants to lose on land to a guy with a pink case. Oh, 4-on-4. As Liquid has another rifle for Elise. He has little HP though. Bomb getting planted inside of the B bomb site by Renegades. And Liquid rotating everybody from the CT spawn.
Vic spamming through that smoke does a decent amount of damage here as Fugly actually comes on through and does take down Havoc. JKS and Spongebob combined, finding the frags here. Fugly, last one up, and he'll go down to JKS's pistol. Another round here for Renegades. Double digits on their T side as Liquid will be able to put an op on Adren in this round and see if that'll make a difference.
Oh, Renegades. Up 10-8. I'm loving these chants as well. We got first the Brazilian, now the Aussie chants. Now 10-8. Renegades. 10 with the buy of Liquid. Adren has the AWP, no utility for him. Just peeking middle, hoping that somebody will try to contest him. Azur near the squeaky. We have the shroud boost as well. Adren gonna get the fight he wanted onto Sponge. So now a deficit for Renegades, and still the player in Squeaky.
Dom is out middle here on the back of Havoc towards Vince. He's got Yam by his side. So what they try to do is Azur will actually retreat out of Squeaky, and with the Molotov out, I was wondering if he was asking if Vince was broken or anything, if he was required to send that Molotov on in, but not going to be the case, as instead, he's going to be waltzing over towards B main with JKS as we provide a little bit of feedback towards a highway, but now they're going to split into the bomb site. They will have a Liege. Team Liquid does, and Azur goes down first and foremost. JKS to follow, and now 2-on-5. A Liege will put a lot of damage into Havoc before going down. Hiko to finish it off, and it's Yam 1v4.
Yep. Yam and a Dam inside of the checkers. He's made his way out, working towards the CT side at any moment. Hiko can peek. And Yam's going to need to hit a sick flick. Grabs the bomb and runs out of there. Yam, you don't got time. But he doesn't want him to have the bomb.
Indeed.
It's my bomb.
Exactly. Might use it against them. As we'll see. Yam looking to again keep this weaponry. Drops a nade, but Nitro pre-firing around the corner. Will not be able to keep that. And $50 on Yam.
Oh, no. He died after the time. Now, Renegades, they have enough to drop two, being Havoc as well as Yam, but that would mean they have a lot less utility to work with, so they're going to go the safe way. They don't need rounds immediately. It's not like Liquid is on the verge of victory. four Ds from Renegades. One away from a Deco. That would bring a tear to my eyes. I love the Decos in Source, but here we go. Renegades going for mid-control. It is going to be an A-split sponge. He's pressed way up by the white box at mid, but Elise trying to find the timing. Renegades have players ready for the peek from middle. And I really like that from the Renegades. Often when you try to split into A, you get flanked from the middle.
Fugly taking down JKS, and it's actually going to be Elise and Fugly combining only Azir now. And he will be trying to find something for himself and Z, but he go with the pistol. We'll be able to put him down in 10 rounds now for Liquid as they put two in a row.
Yeah, I'm only with 1950. See what gun's teammate gonna drop him. Will be an AK. Now I expect Liquid to open up with some form of aggression coming into this one. Where is it going to be? Or they'll just go for their triple mid setup. And Liquid is really impressing me at their ability to trade off on the mid. Let's see if we can see it again. JKS onto a lead. Liquid looking for the trade. Adren will find Sponge. And now Renegades still struggling to take up in the mid. But there's so many Liquid members here. Three frags the way of Liquid. Renegades cannot take mid control. Havoc with two. But the mid hold from Liquid. Immediately when they lose a player, that's when everybody converges. And that's exactly what I was seeing in the last time.
Havoc almost salvaging that situation, actually, as the lines up all those players on Highway Nitro. Was in his sights and dropped fairly low, but we'll be able to connect. Liquid 11 now, taking the lead here. Eco out of Renegades. Deagle on Sponge. As got a couple P250s as well. And Azir will be with the bomb. Looks like I'm interested in peeking out Squeaky here. Sponge to lead that charge. Havoc now heading into A main. And considering this look, Fugly's playing passive on truck. So depending on how they take out here, they don't have any flashes or anything of the sort. But if Fugly doesn't, actually, to be fair, the Squeaky play and Nitro not looking in that direction just yet. Now he will, and perfect timing from him, as my thoughts were that, well, they could make it out. Squeaky could get a bomb plant, but will be Nitro able to deny. Adren with two as well. Nitro onto Yam. JKS can't get it done. And I thought there might have been an opportunity, but again, player on Highway, and then the rest of Liquid shutting it down.
And the amount of nades that Liquid had to rebuy is just maybe like four or five. They didn't have to utilize a lot of their nades that round. And that's going to grow that economy even more. Player over 10K, everybody else able to buy themselves if Renegades lose this. They're going to need to string some together. Are the Renegades. This is Liquid's map choice. First map if you are just joining us. Set up from Liquid, 212.
Kiko with the AWP.
What?
That's very interesting. Generally speaking, if you see a second one out on the field, again, I talked about it in an earlier series, there was a time where Nitro was trying to make it work with that AWP, especially on the T side, allowing Adren to focus more on calling and such, but nope, it is going to be Hiko towards B. So we'll see if he can make it work. Nitro with an M4 towards A, and they have boosted up Fugly.
And set up from Liquid, they've completely abandoned mid. So this allows mid control for the Renegades, but since they got up mid so easily, it begs questions for them. Where is the stack from Liquid? It is at the A-bomb site. Renegades, they will be committing onto A shortly. Have to identify that three players are here really fast, but allowing Renegades to come up connector. The three-pronged assault now, but Adren starts to soft the frag onto Havoc. Response by JKS, Adren burning alive. Two frags with the Molotov for Havoc. And that was in two different positions.
Yeah, very nice stuff there. Elise and Hiko now looking to attempt the retake as Gam drops Hiko, playing a tight angle that Hiko just wasn't able to clear very well. Elise now last one up. See if he can make this expensive at all. As again, Team Liquid with a bit of a bank, whereas Renegade's not the case. There we go. Dropping a second. Can find a third again. That would be huge. Moving into the next round. Then we can drop two. We can not drop three. As Elige hanging around in Z. Like, oh, actually, one going down to the bomb, and Elige picking up that op. He will go down, but again, one player going out of the bomb. Again, that will create that situation I highlighted. Two left up. And rebuying here is Renegades.
All right, got some Aussie hype going on. Liquid still with enough to buy. Pico still sitting above 7K. Strat from Renegades. Spread out so far. Nobody boosting mid. Liquid going with their three-man mid setup. And the Renegades. Got one player on his wing. Making sure nobody pushes Squeaky. JKS watching the B push. Getting further and further up mid is Liquid. Ugly may call for the boost. And three at middle. So if we see a late round mid engagement from Renegades, Liquid is so good at playing off of each other at mid and guaranteeing those trades.
Indeed, as Yam. So a Molotov here, but he's actually not allowed to utilize it as a Molotov goes down near his feet. But Yam and Sponge taking out middle. Fugly to fall to Sponge as well. And, well, generally speaking, like you were highlighting, middle pretty darn good of a hold, but not this round. Adren will fire back, though, take Sponge down. So 2-on-4 as he spots Squeaky Door open. He has players coming at him on all angles, and now it's only Hiko left over at B. As Yam will go down to him, so it's going to be the AWP out of play unless someone goes and picks it up here from Renegades.
Has a Hiko moment written all over it. He wants to go for it. Oh, Havoc. Not going to allow that. 12-12. Renegades rallying back two rounds. Have they finally won enough rounds to put the save onto Liquid? Hiko with 94. Nitro with 66. It's going to come down to if they want utility. And I still think they'll lack a gun on one player. But, yeah, they're going to go for the Force.
There we go. The Force is with them. As
oh, they get a full buy.
They do indeed. Three M4s, two FAMAS. As it's going to be Sponge, opens up, Adren goes down, just blitzing out middle. No early frag for Renegades. It's going to open things very well for themselves. You can see no middle presence for Liquid now. Two on each bomb site. We'll see as JKS is able to drop one player towards B. So falling here is Liquid. 3-on-5.
You lose this. This is a save. Renegades upset Luminosity and then Liquid. Might have to stop considering it an upset pretty soon here. I fully expected to see Liquid versus Cloud9 in the finals. The Renegades showing up tonight. Now Liquid, they have the right bomb site stack. There's five. Scratch that four. Coming into the bomb site for the time being. Fugly lines them up. That's three. And the bomb is in his grasp. And now he has his teammates rotating on through. Fugly continuing through the smoke. Flashbang into the site by Renegades. Both entrances are smoked up. This is brilliant from Liquid. 30 seconds remaining. They have gathered the bomb, but doesn't look like they want to fall back. Is Havoc still lurking in checkers? You see how silent Renegades have gone. That's caused a rotate by Nitro back towards A, but Renegades on to Havoc. Is Nitro coming back? No, both players of JKS as well as Nitro heading back. I don't think Renegades are going to expect to flank this fast from Nitro. Maybe bring down Fugly. Not going to happen. Havoc versus two. Gets the headshot. No chance on the second one as it was an instant trade by Nitro and Liquid fighting back.
Yeah, and that was big plays from Fugly. As I think that was four on the round. Nitro with the last one. Liquid with an impressive B-side hold. Going to put them at 13-12 here as scrambling for a buy is Renegades. Got a Galil on Yam as well as Sponge. Utility, darn good though.
This round is so massive for both teams. Just look at that money. Not even $600 in the hands of Liquid, even less for Renegades. So much attached to this round. And when it's this late into the half on a swing round, it can dictate the match.
Yeah, it certainly can. As we got 20 left in the round here. Pushed up middle is Adren, just waiting underneath the boost. It's going to have the help of a Liege inside of Vents if Renegades wants to try and make a middle play yet again. JKS furthering his position towards B main. And Renegades again recognizing what's on the line in this round. They are going to slowly move towards A.
One of the good things about this setup from Liquid as well, yeah, they're playing 1-3-1. But the rotate is so fast from middle, and that plays into the effectiveness of this setup.
As we still see Hiko actually taking down JKS. Azur with the entry, though, onto Fugly. Sponge to follow it up. It's Adren quick to respond. Coming up from Highway. Takes down Yam. So it will be a 3-on-3 as a post plant setup.
And the player, Havoc, inside of A main, in troublesome, brings down a leash, but the flank comes in from Hiko. Hiko has no HP, can't take a bullet from Havoc and his teammate. Inside of the site, already fighting with the quad player. Everybody so low besides Adren. 2-on-2, hanging on in the back. One at quad, one inside of the site. Now down to Hiko. 7 HP, and he's going to cut his losses. Hiko's not going to go for it. He knows how little time he has remaining, so it's going to be all tied up. And if you look at Liquid's money, they're going to have no round loss bonus, and they're looking at a double save.
This is not looking good at all for the Liquid side as Renegades. Like you had stated, that round could actually be not for the map, but definitely giving one of the teams that step forward.
So if Liquid are planning on double saving, I didn't expect them to buy anything this last round. They may go for the force in the next. This is looking like an upset from Renegades back to back.
As again, Cash is Liquid's map choice. Dust 2 coming up next as Renegades. And you saw them versus Luminosity looking pretty darn good. Well, after losing 10 rounds in a row, that is. As Sponge onto a Liege. Be an entry frag here as, although it is an Eco, they have to be weary about Hiko with that AK. Come alive at any moment. As it will take down Fugly. There's 3 Liquid players remaining, and they're not positioned towards A, and that looks like the target for Renegades.
Yeah, at a big disadvantage. I like that Liquid is just going to group up at middle, try to net themselves one frag at least for the player trying to watch the flank from mid. That is JKS, Hiko. He's going to get another rifle for his teammate. So he's going to collect that. That's Nitro. And they're going to bring it into the next round. This is actually amazing by Liquid. So they bring these 2 rifles into the next, which is going to make them buy in the next, I assume. But given that Liquid didn't invest anything in this round, and they bring out 2 AKs, it's going to give them a shot in the next.
Yeah, not the worst time. Moving into the next round, Renegades 2 away from closing out the map choice of Team Liquid and furthering that potential of the upset you were referring to, as the winner will move into the finals versus Cloud9. As, again, 14 now, and you can see these AKs definitely going to help out the Liquid side, as without those would have been fairly broken a buy. And well, instead now 2 AKs, 2 FAMAS, M4, decent utility, Nitro pretty much the only one without nades.
The more I think about it, it's so smart from Liquid, as they weren't going for the retake, they weren't going for exits, they knew somebody was likely going to be watching the flank from the Renegade, so they group up at mid. Hiko has already gathered himself a rifle, so they're not, they're entirely ignoring the bomb site in that situation. They just wanted guns for this round.
Very smart heads-up play, and again, means they are well-equipped. As Yam has moved up towards Highway at White Box, Sponge towards Vincent. Sponge will actually flash into Checker, trying to make some noise there. They've got Azur towards Squeaky. Currently not making any noise, just holding for a push, but Renegade's just sitting on this mid control.
And Trent thinking about peeking back towards mid. There's still a smoke up for the Renegades, shrouding Adren's peak position if he wants to. But with this player inside events, I think we're going to see the commitment from Renegades. A re-smoke from mid. There is a hole in it running through the smoke. They're going to go into the CT spawn. Adren around the corner in time to save himself from Sponge, and then he kills him inside of the bomb site. Down goes Fugly to Azur, but there's a very fast flank underway from Nitro. Misses his first shot. Yam onto Adren. Liquid, they lose this round. Tie point claimed by Renegades, and the next buy will not be good for Liquid.
Liege takes down JKS. Yam onto Hiko. 2-on-3 as you're going to see Nitro trying to make something work here. Does spam down Yam as a Liege can't capitalize. Havoc peeking from Squeaky. Nitro going to be very difficult here as he's hopping around. Flash provided towards Squeaky. Picks up Kid as well, but it's Azur from quad, peeks out wide, and Renegades 15-13.
This is happening again. I'm sure you can hear the crowd going wild. Renegades going through the lower bracket, first eliminating Luminosity, and now going to take map one potentially over Liquid. Liquid fighting for the tie. 4 pistols on board. Hiko with the 5 sevens for everybody else. They do have a good amount of utility. Now we see some aggression coming from the Liquid side towards B. Only one player at mid, and that's Adren, firing away with the 5-7 entry from JKS. He might even look for the other one. Hiko spamming away, creates a little bit of damage. Now Sponge to come back. Hiko, is he expecting him? No, this could be it. 16-13, I can't believe it. Nitro is going to even things out a bit, and as Azur will go down. So 3-on-4, Liquid need to retake this B site.
Yeah, not a lot of utility. They do have an incendiary flash and a smoke as they arrive on scene. The bomb not yet set, so that'll give them ample time to try and make this retake a reality. But that Molotov will set them back as the bomb goes down. Actually, we'll go out. I'm actually uncertain what happened there, but we will see Havoc onto Adren. It's going to be Nitro coming into the bomb site. Takes down Havoc. JKS, though, onto Fugly now. Only Nitro needs the clutch to keep this map Dreno alive, but they're playing this very well. Yeah, I'm holding an off angle, and he will connect. 16-13. Renegades take it.
Yeah, I think they have the secret recipe. They need to give up the first 5 or 10 rounds, and then comes the upset to follow. Renegades.
Apparently.
Map number one, Cash. Liquid is incredibly strong on Cash.
That is a statement. Man. If I've ever seen one. And again, Dust 2 is our next map, and we saw what Renegades was capable of versus Luminosity, but who knows, maybe Liquid saw some weaknesses in those 10 rounds that Luminosity did exploit, so.
Yeah, I'm definitely thinking they were watching that.
Oh, for sure.
And it's all the more incredible that Renegades were able to win on Dust 2, considering that they went down 10-0. And Liquid's got to be thinking about that, too.
Yeah, indeed, as we are going to cut to a short break, but very soon we'll be moving into map 2 of this lower bracket final. Don't go too far, guys. You don't want to miss this, as we will be right back.